वेलकम टू द चैनल फिजिक्स बाय आईआईटीएंस। टुडे वी आर बैक हियर विद अनदर इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन एंड दिस क्वेश्चन वाज आस्क्ड इन आईआईटी इंदौर टू सम ऑफ माय फ्रेंड्स। ओके एंड द क्वेश्चन इज नॉन एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन एन एटॉमिक न्यूक्लियस। एक्चुअली दे आस्क द क्वेश्चन दैट कैन ए फ्री इलेक्ट्रॉन एग्जिस्ट इनसाइड एन एटॉमिक न्यूक्लियस। That was the question, and surely it is no. And then they told him that okay, please do it mathematically. Okay, so you have to mathematically to find out. You have to apply Heisenberg uncertainty principle. We all know that Heisenberg uncertainty principle is delta x into delta p should be greater than or equals to h cross. Now let's find out how to find out the non-existence of free electrons in an atomic nucleus. Okay, so we all know that the rest mass of an electron m naught is 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg, and the diameter of an atomic nucleus is about 10 to the power minus 4 meter. Okay, you write this as 14 meter is an approximate value, and in interview you can roughly write that as 10 to the power minus 14 meter or 10 to the power minus 15 meter, and you write m naught accurately. Okay, and then you should calculate the maximum possible energy for the electrons. And we all know the electrons emitted from a radioactive nucleus is of energy 4 mega electron volt. Now we calculate it for the free electrons inside an atomic nucleus. Okay, so now if possible for an electron to exist in the nucleus, okay, it would lie anywhere within the diameter d of the nucleus. Okay, and the maximum uncertainty in the position of the electron would be delta x, that is the diameter of the nucleus d, and it should be 2 into 10 to the power minus 14 meter. Now according to Heisenberg uncertainty principle, that delta x into delta p is greater than equals to h cross. So delta p is the uncertainty in the momentum of the electron. The minimum uncertainty in the momentum should be delta p equals to h cross by delta x, which we get 0.527 into 10 to the power minus 20 kg meter second inverse. So this is the minimum momentum, P minimum. Okay, now you calculate the relativistic energy E of the electron, that is E square equals to P square C square plus M naught square C to the power 4. So E minimum, you can write it as E minimum square equals to P minimum square C square plus M naught square C to the power 4. So you substitute the value of P minimum C M naught square square C to the power 4, and you find out the value as 9.88 mega electron volt. Now what is the conclusion? Conclusion is that a free electron must have an energy of at least 9.88 mega electron volt in order to exist in the nucleus. Okay, but as the minimum kinetic energy of an electron emitted from a radioactive nucleus is only 4 mega electron volt, that is beta rays. Okay, they are order of, their energies are the order of 4 mega electron volt. So it follows that free electrons cannot exist in atomic nuclei, because the range of the energy we are getting from the free electron, that is 9.88 mega electron volt. Okay, so this is a very important interview question. Hopefully you write it, like it. Thank you.